Let's see if we can rewrite 6/12 as a decimal. And once again, I encourage you to pause this video and try this on your own, and I'll give you a little hint. See if you can rewrite this fraction, not in terms of twelfths, but in terms of tenths. Well, let's just visualize this thing. So let's say that this right over here, is a twelfth. So that is a twelfth. And so let me try to make 12 twelfths. So copy and paste that. So that's 2/12. That's 2/12. And that is 3/12. And that is, actually, let me just copy and paste the 3/12. So copy and paste. So now we have 6/12, which I'll color it in a second. And now we have 9/12. And now we have 12/12. 12/12 right over there. And what we care about 6 of these 12ths, or this is representing 6 of these 12ths. So let me see if I can color in 6 of them. So let me see if I can pull this off. So this is going to be 1, let me do a bigger paintbrush. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's right, that's 6/12. Let me just color all of this business in. So there you have. We have represented our fraction. Now how do we represent this thing right over here in terms of tenths? So the one thing that I might want to do is, well look, 6 and 12 are both divisible by 6. So what if we divide this, not if we rewrite this whole not in terms of twelfths, but we write it in terms of halves. Well, how would we do that? Well, we could call all of this stuff, this is 1/2, and this is another half. Or another way of thinking about it is, we're taking 6 of our 12s together, and then we're putting them together, and we're turning them into a half. So in terms of the number of sections we have, we're dividing the number of sections we have by 6. So let's do that. So let's divide the number of sections by 6. So now we're only going to have 2 sections. We're only going to have 2 halves. That right over there is 1/2. And that right over there is the other half. Notice, we had 12/12. Now we're taking 6 of those at a time, putting them together. So now we only have 2 sections instead of 12 sections. But those six twelfths, what are they going to be in halves? Well, once again, we're taking 6 of the things and putting them together into 1. So we're going to divide that by 6 as well. Divide that by 6 as well. And so this is going to be the same thing as 1/2. And you see this 1/2. You see this 1/2 right over here. And notice, all we did, in the past we had multiplied the numerator and the denominator by the same quantity to get an equivalent fraction. Now we're dividing the numerator and the denominator by the same quantity to get the same fraction. Hopefully this makes sense, that 1/2 is equivalent to 6/12. Now why did I do that? Didn't I say that I wanted to get this in terms of tenths? And yes, I do want to get it in terms of tenths, but 1/2 is fairly easy to rewrite in terms of tenths. So let me re-express 1/2. So 1/2, let me write it like this. So 1/2, I could represent 1/2 again. I'm going to re-represent 1/2. So let's say this right over here is clearly 1/2. So I'm just re-representing it. So I'm taking a whole, dividing it into 2, and 1/2, let me just color it in. 1/2 would be that right over there, which as we already seen, it's equivalent to the 6/12. Now I want to write this as tenths. So what if I take each of those halves and I turn it into 5 times as many pieces? I turn it into 5 times as many pieces. So let me do that. So I'm going to do it into 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So what did I just do? I multiplied, I now have 5 times as many pieces, and the 1/2 is going to represent 5 times as many tenths. So this is going to be equal to 5 over 10. 5 over, let me do that in that green color, 5 tenths. Notice, 6 twelfths is the same thing as 1 half, which is the same thing as 5 tenths. All I did here is I multiplied the numerator and the denominator by the same quantity, 5, so I could get 10 in the denominator. And 5 tenths, well, that's the same thing as 5 times 1 tenth. It's literally 5 tenths. And we can represent this as a decimal, or you could kind of say in decimal notation. 5 tenths, we know that, let's say that that is the ones place. And if we go one place to the right of the decimal, that is the tenths place. That right over there is the tenths place. And we have 5 tenths, so we would put a 5 right over there. So this could be rewritten as the decimal 0.5. Now there's other ways you could have thought about it. You could say, hey, look, 6 is half of 12. And so what is half of 10? Well, 5 is half of 10. And so 5 over 10 is the same thing as 5 tenths, or which is the same thing as 5 tenths written as a decimal.